Isang mapagpalang umaga po sa ating lahat. Inaanyayahan ko pong lahat na yumuko at ipikit ang ating mga mata. Tayo po ay manalangin. Panginoon, isang magandang umaga po sa iyo. Gusto ka po naming pasalamatan, Lord, dahil tunay na ikaw pong siyang nagtipon sa amin ngayon. Lord, we pray na kayo pong siyang manguna sa aming parambahan, Panginoon. Kayo po ang siyang magbukas na aming puso't isipan, Lord. Sa dami ng mga struggles ngayon, Panginoon, ng circumstances sa buhay, Panginoon, we know, Lord, na ikaw ang tanging dahilan ng aming pagpapatuloy sa buhay, Lord. Tunay, Lord, na you are the way, the truth, and the life, Panginoon. That's why, Lord, this morning, Panginoon, tulungan niyo po kami na awitan kayo ng buong-buo nang galing sa aming mga puso't isip. At ganun din po, Panginoon, tulungan niyo kami na santabi muna, panandalian yung mga iniisip namin, Panginoon, at ibigay namin tong oras na to, Panginoon, right at this very moment, for us to praise you, Panginoon, to worship you, because you deserve the highest praise, Panginoon. In Jesus' name we pray, Amen. I invite everyone po to please stand and samahan niyo po kami na umawit sa ating Panginoon.
Cause you're the only one I need. I turn to you when you are always there. In troubled times it's you I see. I put you first, that's all I need. I humble all I am, oh to you. Yesterday, today, the same. Forever till forever, it's no end.
Side for
Patuloy po tayong umawit para sa ating Panginoon. Dahil tunay nga po na marami man mga pagkakaiba sa buhay, sa perspective natin, marami man yung mga pinagdadaanan natin, andun yung meron tayong isang desire. Yun yung makapiling ang ating Panginoon na maramdaman yung presensya niya sa araw-araw, na sa bawat pagising natin, nandun yung sa Kanya tayo nag-look up. Sa Kanya tayo humuhugot ng lakas at ang lahat-lahat sa atin.
To be with you, it's to be.
For the reading of His Word, let us open our Bibles in Acts chapter 15, verses 36 to 41. Again, it is in Acts chapter 15, verses 36 to 41. And the Word of the Lord says, "Sometime later, Paul said to Barnabas, 'Let us go back and visit the believers in all the towns where we preach the Word of the Lord and see how they are doing.' Barnabas wanted to take John, also called Mark, with them. But Paul did not think it wise to take him, because he had deserted them in Pamphylia and had not continued with them in the work. They had such a sharp disagreement that they parted company. Barnabas took Mark and sailed for Cyprus, but Paul chose Silas and left, commended by the believers to the grace of the Lord. He went through Syria and Cilicia, strengthening the churches." Blessed be the name of the Lord for the reading of His Word.
Magandang araw po sa lahat. Today, we will make a follow-up message on that faithful disagreement between Paul and Barnabas. Para sa akin, this account in the book of Acts is the saddest part of the history of the early church. Kasi here are two great men of God who have previously helped unite the church, and yet they could not agree with each other. Hindi sila magkaintindihan, and yet for a previous months, previous weeks, magkasama silang pinag-unite yung church. Painful and disturbing as these conflicts are, the Bible tells us that God reveals Himself in history, and this incident is no exception. And we have learned last Sunday that God allows terrible things to happen for our own good, Kaya may apat na katanungan akong ibibigay sa inyo sa araw na to. Una, naranasan nyo na bang ma-reject? Pangalawa, naranasan mo na bang mang-reject? Pangatlo, naranasan mo na bang tumanggap ng reject? Pang-apat, naranasan mo na bang masaksihan firsthand ang mga pangyayaring tulad ng ganito? And what was your response? Ano yung inyong naging feeling or what was your reaction or your response to that kind of incident or that kind of happening? Now, there are several things that we can learn here. Of course, alam natin that God was at work in spite of the seeming obstacles and personal difficulties that arose. So today, let us unfold together on responding well in adversities. So we'll go back again to Acts chapter 15, verses 36 to 41. But before that, let us pray. Father, we give you praise, we give you honor, we give you glory. This is your day, this is your time that you have given to us. And we are glad and we will rejoice in it. Salamat, Lord, for this opportunity and for this privilege, Lord, that we can hear from you again, from your words. So, Lord, we ask you to open up our hearts and our minds so that we can understand you clearly and fully of what you are going to teach us today. Maraming salamat because even, Lord, in what is really happening all around us today, you are still in control. At maraming salamat for that, Father, because today is a good day. Today is a great day for all of us. So, Father, here we are, your servants. We will sit down at your feet. Lord, speak to us and we will listen to you. This is our prayer in Jesus' name. Amen and amen. Again, responding well in adversities. How we are going to respond well in adversities. At ito yung ating matutunan sa araw na to. We all know that after Paul, Barnabas, or Judas, Barsabas, and Silas, after na na-deliver nila yung letter na nanggaling doon sa council sa Jerusalem, para doon sa mga mostly non-Jewish churches in Syria and Cilicia, they spent time together there in Antioch of Syria. So, again, alalahanin natin na maraming Antioch sa Bible, especially sa the Book of Acts. And this time, this is Antioch of Syria. This is different to that Antioch in Caesarea where Peter met yung si Cornelius. Now, the church of Syria became the base of Paul and Barnabas' missionary journeys. Ito yung kanilang home church. And after ministering to the people there, Barsabas went back to Jerusalem, but surprisingly, Silas chose to remain. Now, here, makikita natin na from the start of itong part na to sa verse 31, na Paul is not the type who will settle down and be comfortable in his ministry. Hindi siya yung tipong, okay na ako rito, okay na to, dito na lang ako. No. Nangati yung kanya mga paa, kaya he proposed to Barnabas to visit the churches that they planted para makita nila kung how the churches were doing and how the believers there have been doing. And Barnabas, like Paul, has the same thinking about ministry. So he agreed. Malamang sinabi ni Barnabas, cool, whenever you're ready, let's go. Now the disagreement between the two arose when Paul saw that Barnabas is bringing John Mark with them. Alam natin na Paul disagreed because he remembered that incident when John Mark abandoned them in Pamphylia. Yung iniwanan lang silang bigla ni John Mark at umuwi si John Mark doon sa Jerusalem. To Paul, he doesn't want baggage in his team. It will only slow them down. Sa kanyang pakiramdam, kung dadalhin si Mark, Mark will only slow them down. And so, Dr. Luke would then record that Paul and Barnabas had not just a heated argument, but it was a sharp disagreement. Nag-away ba sila? Sigurado. And how did they resolve their conflict bago sila magkasakitan? Ang kanilang naging resolution as they have to parted ways. They have to part ways. So, Barnabas and John Mark went southwest to the island of Cyprus while Paul and Silas went through Syria and Cilicia. Okay, naghiwalay sila. So, a question was posed to us last Sunday. Last Sunday's message, Pastor Mel posed to us, sino ba ang tama sa kanila? Who was right? You see, I would say that both men were right. And at the same time, both men were wrong. Kasi ganito, Paul is like, what can Mark do for God's work? Ano ba ang magagawa ni Mark para sa gawain ng Panginoon? Yun yung kanyang mindset. But Barnabas is different. Kay Barnabas naman is that, what can God's work do to Mark? Ano ang magagawa ng gawain ng Panginoon para sa ikalalago ni Mark? What can God's work do to Mark? So talagang, both of them were correct, but they are poles apart. But you know what? Both questions are very important to God's work today. It was very important to God's work before, and it's still very important itong mga question na to today. This is where we should strike a balance. But again, it is easier said than done. Okay? Both men were not able to respond well in that instant. So they quarreled. Nag-away sila. Sharp disagreement kasi hindi lang siya normal na discussion or normal na diskusyon. It was really a sharp disagreement. At masasabi natin na nagkaroon talaga sila ng quarrel at nag-away sila, nagkasagutan ng malakasan. So what about Mark and Silas who had surely heard the shouting match between Paul and Barnabas? Now, Barnabas accepted or rejected because he sees the potential in the young John Mark. Tumanggap ng reject si Barnabas dahil he has to encourage or encourage a colossal failure like Mark. Alam natin ng pangalang Barnabas is a son of encouragement. So, si Barnabas saw something in John, which leads us to the first point that we would learn here sa mga bersikulo na to. Point number one, mga kapatid, that we should not discount the potential and value of each person. I'll repeat it again. We should not discount the potential and value of each person. Ano ang nakita ni Barnabas kay Mark na hindi nakita ni Paul? What did Barnabas saw in Mark that Paul did not see? Is it because blood is thicker than water? Because Barnabas and Mark were cousins? Para sa akin, mga kapatid, it is more than that. Barnabas saw something in Mark that he could work on. Mark became Barnabas' big project of discipleship. You see, Barnabas did not let Mark remain a failure and a loser. Barnabas gave Mark the right motivation so that Mark will succeed in life and in ministry. To make it short, he gave Mark a second chance. So being an encourager, Barnabas knew what the wise man said in Proverbs 12:25. Anxiety weighs down the heart, but a kind word cheers it up. Ito, exactly ang kailangan ni Mark. He needs this at this point in his Christian life. He needs encouragement. Naa-anxious siya sa sitwasyon na yun. And Barnabas knows that pretty well. Mark needs encouragement so that he can continue in his Christian life, so that he can continue in his Christian walk. So Barnabas taught Mark many things, and the most important thing that Barnabas taught Mark is not to hold a grudge against Paul. Na hindi tinuruan niya si Mark na huwag magalit kay Paul. Tinuruan niya si Mark na huwag magkimkim ng galit or ng pagtatampo. Na huwag niyang gawing magtampo siya kay Paul or to hold a grudge. You see, Barnabas knows his scriptures. And certainly he knows that holding grudges is against the law of Moses. Sabi nga sa Leviticus 19:18, it says, do not seek revenge or bear a grudge against anyone among your people. But love your neighbor as yourself. I am the Lord. Isn't it that the Lord Jesus Christ mentioned this also? Love your neighbor as yourself, telling us not to hold a grudge. The Lord Jesus Christ Himself told us not to hold a grudge. Ang sabi niya, instead of holding a grudge, forgive, for you have been forgiven. Sabi niya sa Mark 11:25, "And when you stand praying, if you hold anything against anyone, forgive them, so that your Father in heaven may forgive you your sin." Barnabas may have lost his cool and argued sharply with Paul, but he did not let that incident affect his ministry. Sabi nga, the show must go on. Did he responded well in that incident? After the incident, did he responded well? Mga kapatid, you be the judge. Kayo na po ang humusga. Mark knew that he was rejected like one of no value. Alam ko na sa mafi-feel ko yung napagkakataon na yun, and when he was rejected by Paul, na ang pakiramdam niya, he has no value at all. Naramdaman niya kung gaano kasakit ang ma-reject. You see, I have my own experience of being unwanted and rejected. Well, this is work-related and this is professionally. When I was starting with my career, you see, I am the kind of, you know, na go lang ng go. Bahala na kung anong mangyari dyan. And so, people doesn't like that. And they don't like me to be in their team. There was one instant that one supervisor, this is in the early 90s, na looking at the design that I made, na they were doing at the field, na para to embarrass me or siguro to teach me a lesson, talagang ginawa niya sa radyo. Radyo pa nung time na yun, wala pang cellphone, wala pang text eh. So, radyo pa, yung sure, ano bang tawag doon? Single sideband or something, what do you call that? My wife knows this very well because she's a licensed radio operator. She's a first class radio telephony operator. So, alam niya kung ano yung mga bagay na yan. So, ang nangyari, nagtawag sa radyo, doon sa base namin, at nagtanong kung sino yung DTP. Well, DTP is my initial. That's Dante P. Pollescas. Sino ba to? Ay, si Dante yan, sir. Tingnan ako, kausapin ko sa radyo. Sabi niya ganyan. Ano tong ginawa mo? This is not correct. Punta ka rito at sayaw-sayawan mo tong ginawa mong design. So, I mean, this kind of experience na you're unwanted and you're being rejected and your work is being rejected is really, really hard and it's really painful. But it taught me a very, very important lesson. And this is same thing na dapat nagawin din natin because this is what Mark did. Yung kanyang rejection, he responded well in that adverse situation, yung pangyayari na yon. He responded well to that, which leads us to the next point, that second chances are rare, so we have to respond to it well. Pag binigyan tayo ng second chance, mga kapatid, respond to it well because it is only given, you know. Minsan baka hindi tayo bigyan. So that's why second chances are rare, so we have to respond to it well. You see, Barnabas was an excellent mentor. He is not just a good mentor. He was an excellent mentor. Under his mentorship, Mark grew spiritually. Mark grew matured and he became a faithful servant. Mark responded well to that second chance that was given to him, to the mentorship of his Kuya Barney. He did not just settle the mentorship of his cousin Barnabas. He wanted more. You see, nung binigyan siya ng second chance at nagkasama sila ni Barnabas in the ministry sa Cyprus and who knows kung saan sila nagpunta uli with all this visiting na ginawa nila, si Mark, deep inside his heart, he wanted more. Kaya, after their stint together, after nung magkasama sila, Mark became one of the trusted mentee of Peter. So that Peter would call him his son. You see, sa 1 Peter 5:13, ang sabi ni Peter doon, he considered Mark as his son. She who is in Babylon, sabi niya, chosen together with you, sends you her greetings, and so does my son Mark. So ibig sabihin right now, Mark is rubbing elbows with who's who in the early church. He's now with Peter. After with Barnabas, he's now with Peter. You can just imagine what kind of mentorship and what kind of learning he has done because he responded well to the second chance that was given to him. Peter calls him my son, indicating that they have this bond, they have this kind of closeness. Well, if we will go back to Acts chapter 12, we will know there that Peter was a good friend of Mark's mother, Mary. You see, it was during this time that Mark was with Peter that he heard the details of Jesus Christ's life and ministry. First hand from Peter, narinig niya kung ano yung life and ministry of the Lord Jesus Christ. You see, that rejection, after all, became Mark's launching pad to become a success. Hindi siya nagmukmuk sa sulok. He did not sit down in one corner and nag-self-pity. Na bahala kayo dyan, kayo na. No, he did not. He made that second chance or that, you know, that situation to be a launching pad for him to succeed. You see, mga kapatid, the gospel that bears the name Mark was the first gospel ever written. Accordingly, there were some, but those were incomplete. Ito yung pinakaunang gospel na sinulat na kumpleto. And you see, you can sense that in the manner that it was written, it bears the imprints of his mentor, Peter. Kasi alam natin na sa Peter ay, you know, yung impulsive, lagi nagmamadali. That's why in the Gospel of Mark, you can read the words immediately. Kailangan, immediately. It really bears the imprints of Peter through Mark. If Mark did not responded well to that second chance that was given to him, wala sana tayong yung the gospel according to Mark. We owe it to him. We owe it to the second chance that was given to him. We owe it to his, you know, responding well to the second chance that was given to him. You see, I like what the good Dr. Averell Argon wrote. He described Mark as a successful failure. Now, are you a failure today? Have you been given a second chance to redeem yourself? You see, mga kapatid, we have to remember this, that our God, the Lord Jesus Christ, is a God of second chances. Now, what about Paul? What can we learn from him in this incident? You see, don't get me wrong. Paul was a good man. He wouldn't become the greatest evangelist of all time if he was not. Paul was just an overly passionate man in everything that he do. You see, look at what he did to the early church because of his passion for the Word of God, for the passion of what he have learned. Yung kanyang mga natutunan, he put it into action. That's how passionate Paul. You see, he was an overly passionate man in everything that he do. And here, mga kapatid, I believe that it was because of this passion, it was because of his passion over things that the Lord Jesus Christ called him to his service. But in this case, mga kapatid, he went overboard and it destroyed his relationship with Barnabas. You see, we have to bear in mind that Barnabas was Paul's mentor. Okay, kung babalikan natin sa Acts chapter 9, 10, I think, 10, 11, it was Barnabas who defended Paul against the refusal of the leaders in Jerusalem to accept him as part of the movement. You see, kaya he was sent back to Tarsus, and it was Barnabas who fetched him in Tarsus and gave him the chance to prove himself in the gospel ministry. But Paul's passion destroyed him momentarily. Which leads us to the third point that we are going to learn in this very special section of the book of Acts, that we should not let our passion get over our head at the expense of others. Don't let your passion get over your head at the expense of others. You know what I mean? Na kung gusto mo, ito yung gusto mo, because you're so passionate about this, you do everything, bahala na masagasaan lahat. You see, don't let your passion get over your head at the expense of others. And you see, I have my own experience because, like, you know, I am also a very passionate man. But, you know, as age caught me up, I started to realize na if we have a misplaced passion, it will alienate people from us. And this is exactly what Paul has experienced. You see, si Paul kasi was the kind of man that would say na yung trabaho ngayon should have been done 5 days ago. Ganun siya ka-passionate, ganun siya kabilis. That is why he rejected the idea of bringing Mark again, because at the back of his mind, the ministry, the gospel, the spreading of the gospel will slow them down if Mark is with them. So we would never know if Paul and Barnabas reconciled because there was no record about it. Walang naisulat kung nag-reconcile ba si Paul at saka si Barnabas. You see, Barnabas was no longer mentioned in the scriptures. In fact, kung binasa natin, kung babasahin natin dito, Barnabas, parang hindi siya naka-receive ng commendation. It was Silas and Paul. He was commended, they were commended. But Barnabas, no. Diba? Well, Barnabas was no longer mentioned in the scriptures after this incident, except for some reference about him that Paul mentioned in his letter to the Corinthians and the Galatians. Makikita natin doon na minention ni Paul yung kanyang pangalan ni Barnabas. But in fact, when he mentioned Barnabas' name twice in his letter to the Galatian believers, it bears a negative connotation. But you see, mga kapatid, one thing for sure. Paul was remorseful of that incident and surely he regretted it very much. Nagsisi si Paul doon. You see, bakit ko nasabi yun? Kasi 15 years later, he would speak good things about Mark in his letters to the Colossians and Philemon. What did he say about Mark? Anong sinabi ni Paul kay Mark? Sabi niya sa mga taga-Colosse, sabi niya, Mark is my fellow prisoner, just like with Aristarchus, that he sends you his greetings as does Mark and the cousin of Barnabas. Sabi niya, you have received instructions about him. If he comes to you, welcome him. Wow! Yung dating ni-reject ni Paul, ngayon, kasama niya na. What does that mean? Now, I know that Paul realized that Barnabas did the good thing of giving Mark, you know, the chance to Mark, giving Mark a chance because he knows that Mark has a potential. Right now, Mark is part of the ministry that is helping Paul. And Paul, sabi niya, use instructions about him. If he comes to you, welcome him. You see? Nakikita ko rito yung remorse ni Paul, yung kanyang regrets because 15 years after he met, meron siyang kasama na uli si Mark. Mark was with him in prison in Rome, the cousin of Barnabas. Mark has grown and become useful in the ministry. Now, this is what I'm talking about, what Barnabas told Mark. Do not hold grudge with Paul. Huwag kang magalit kay Paul. Talking about not holding grudges, right? So Mark made himself available para samahan si Paul sa detention cell nito sa Rome. And then, in his letter to Philemon, sabi niya, Epaphras, my fellow prisoner in Christ, Jesus sends you greetings, and so do Mark. See, magkasama sila doon sa Rome. Mark was with him. Mark now is very useful in his ministry, and without Barnabas. There was no record of their reconciliation, but I'm sure they reconciled. I'm sure of that because Mark is now with him. Mark, he can see now the work of Barnabas to the life of Mark. That's it. All three major characters of this incident has made their place in the history books of the early church. Although nothing was heard from Barnabas after this, yung kanyang accomplishments in the life of his cousin Mark was the megaphone of his presence all throughout the Bible. Mark turned out to be a big-time success from being a colossal failure. And Paul, the Lord has taught him a very valuable lesson in life, that your strength may become your weakness if you will not be careful. I'll repeat it again. Your strength, our strength, may become our weakness if we will not be careful. And that's precisely the lesson that Paul learned. He became a more reasonable man in the latter part of his ministry. His epistles will tell you about the change in his character and behavior. Read the epistles of Paul and you can see there kung gaano nagbago yung kanyang buhay. You see all those principles and advices that he gave to the early church. So where does Silas fit in the picture? He was like an unwitting victim who was caught in the crossfire between Paul and Barnabas, two big guns of the early church. You see, in situations like this, mga kapatid, your capacity and your ability will be put into a spotlight. Parang naka-spotlight ka. Perhaps, only perhaps, Barnabas also questioned Paul's decision to choose Silas over his cousin Mark. And can you picture the eyes of Mark? Can you see that? Can you picture his face? Perhaps Mark felt offended by the presence of Silas. Why would he stay in Antioch when his role was just to accompany Paul and Barnabas to ensure na yung letter na ipinadala sa kanila ay maipabasa at ma-delivered well into the churches? But we all know that Silas was no ordinary man. He was described by Luke as a prophet and an encourager. We'll go back to verse 31. It says, Judas and Silas, who themselves were prophets, said much to encourage and strengthen the believers. They were prophets. Silas was a prophet. Silas was not affected by the situation. He was firm on his calling. He stood strong and held on to what would be his role in this situation, a new companion and helper of Paul, which will lead us to the last point of the message today. God allows things to happen to accomplish His will. Just obey. Okay? God allows things to happen to accomplish His will. Just obey. God prepared Silas for that situation. He will become the perfect partner of Paul in his second ministry journey, in his second missionary journey. Because like Paul, Silas was a Roman citizen. And that would make them a very powerful tandem as they embark on their missionary journeys in Europe. God was clearly in control, right? Can I hear an amen to that, mga kapatid? Silas responded well by not being sidetracked by that incident to what God wants him to do. Silas obeyed and stuck with God's leading. Ito yung leading ng Panginoon. I have to stick with it. Yung sabi ni Silas. Warren W. Wiersbe said something that I will quote, that God changes His workmen, but His work goes right on. Nagbabago yung mga worker, but yung work ng Panginoon is the same and it will go on. You see, meron ng dalawang missionary teams instead of one. It's a reality, mga kapatid, that God doesn't depend on perfect people to accomplish His work. We know that if He does, nothing will ever be done kung ang gagawin niya perfect. Kasi walang perfect na tao. And God knows that. Nothing will ever be done if He will find perfect people here on earth. Nobody is perfect. So He doesn't depend on perfect people. He depends on people like us to accomplish His work. We have to respond well in any adversity and challenges. All we have to do is trust God and obey. And this is the truth that all of us should always bear in mind, that should always remember, that the Lord Jesus Christ in the Great Commission, when He gave the Great Commission, He commanded us not just to know, but to obey His teachings. Ang ibig sabihin, alam natin, but we have to put it into action, yung Kanyang teaching. What did He say? Ang sabi ng Panginoon Jesus Kristo sa Kanyang mga disipulo, teaching them to obey everything I have commanded you, and surely I will be with you always to the very end of the age. Hindi niya sinabing teaching them to know. Hindi niya sinabing to teach us, for us to know. No. Ang sabi niya, to teach us to obey. Teaching them to obey everything that He have commanded, yung Kanyang mga katuruan. Once na matutunan natin, we have to put it into action. This is the very essence of the Christian life. As we walk with God, as we walk with the ministry, and as we continue with our journey and we have this learning in our mind and in our hearts, it has to be put into action. That is what the Lord Jesus Christ meant in obey. You see, our knowledge is useless if we will not apply it and make it into action and put it into action. His promise that as we obey Him, He will be with us always. Yun yung promise ng Panginoon Hesus Kristo sa atin. Not just today, not just tomorrow, but always. Ang sabi nga niya, to the end of the age. All we have to do in all the adversities that we have right now, that we have to respond well in this right now what we're doing, in this pandemic, this is an adversity. This is a very adverse situation. We have to respond well in this. And the promise of the Lord Jesus Christ that He will be with us always up to the end of the age. This is the reason why we are studying the book of Acts. To learn from the early church. To learn from these ordinary men who have turned the world upside down. I will leave you with this quote, mga kapatid, before we end our worship service this morning. Our limitations and our imperfections are good reasons for us to depend on the grace of God, for our sufficiency is from Him alone. Again, I'll repeat it. Our limitations and imperfections are good reasons for us to depend on the grace of God, for our sufficiency is from Him alone. God bless po sa ating lahat. Be empowered by the Holy Spirit. Amen and amen.
Dance in your presence.
doubts in your presence, who doubts in your presence, oh, 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 King of glory, I feel this place, I just want to be with you.
As it is written in Malachi 3:10, bring the whole tithe into the storehouse, that there may be food in my house. Test me in this, says the Lord Almighty, and see if I will not throw open the floodgates of heaven and pour out so much blessing that there will not be room enough to store it. At this time around, we invite everyone to support our ministries by giving our tithes and offering. You can send it via bank transfer. Our account name is Alliance Bible Christian Church, and account number is 0010100111240. As you do it now, let's watch this video.
Thank you.
Again, we thank you for your kind hearts to support our church and ministries. May the Lord bless all your works, businesses, allowances, and other sources of income. Si Lord na po ang bahalang magbabalik nito ng siksik, liglig, at maapaw. Also, we greet each and everyone who celebrates their birthdays for this week. Dalangin po namin na mas at maging healthy at manatiling healthy and blessed ang inyong mga buhay sa dagdag na taon na binigay ni Lord. And for our other announcements and benediction, let us hear again from Pastor Dante.
Before po tayo magtapos sa ating worship service this morning, today, meron na po tayong mga karagdagang announcement. On March 6 po, March 6, 2022, at 9 a.m. in the morning, we'll be going back to face-to-face dito po sa ating bahay-sambahan sa ABCC. Face-to-face worship po is back on March 6, 2022. That would be on the first Sunday of March. That would be next Sunday. So, everybody is invited to come over and enjoy the fellowship with the Lord. Just be sure that you are fully vaccinated and you have your mask, okay? So everybody, come over here on Sunday for our face-to-face, for the resumption of our face-to-face worship. And of course, meron pa rin tayong live broadcast. This will be beamed by live streaming our worship service on March 6 and onwards, okay? So mga kapatid, I'm excited. I hope that you'll be excited to come over, join us in our face-to-face, the resumption of our face-to-face worship on March 6. And another announcement, we would like to invite, if you feel that you want to be part of the ministry, especially sa ating praise and worship ministry dito sa church, if you know how to play guitar, if you know how to play the drums, if you know how to sing, you are welcome to be part of the team. Okay? So come over, send me a note, send me a text, send me a private message. Na, you know, you're willing to join in the ministry sa praise and worship. You see, the praise and worship in our church is an integral part of our worship service. So it's also very, very important. So we're inviting you to be part of the ministry, mga kapatid. Okay? So much for that. I would like everybody to stand up and let's have this closing prayer and benediction. Lord, maraming salamat for your message today. Salamat for the reminders. Salamat, Lord, sa napakaikling mga verses, Lord, na naisulat sa chapter 15 ng Acts that you allowed to be recorded so that all of us, Lord, will be able to learn. Last Sunday, we were taught on how to resolve conflict. Na sabihin, yung aming kasagutan ay hindi namin yun kaaway. Thank you for that, for reminding us. Kasi minsan, Lord, talagang hindi namin na nakakalimutan namin yun, Lord, na hindi naman sila kaaway. Sometimes our emotions will only get the best of us. And for your reminders today, Father, from the lives of Barnabas, from the lives of Mark, from the lives of Apostle Paul, and for the life of Silas. Salamat, Lord, for the reminder. And sana, Lord, yung aming narinig ngayon na nailagay namin sa aming mga puso, learning that we will put it, Lord, into action. That we will put it, Lord, into action just like as we will obey, Lord, your great commission. Salamat, Father, because this church has a special calling to reach out people from all walks of life. And you have establish us, Lord, this church, Lord, so that we can reach out people who hasn't known your Son, the Lord Jesus Christ yet. So maraming salamat, Lord, for this week na alam namin na kasama namin kayo to strengthen us, to empower us. And Lord, para gamitin namin, Lord, kung ano man yung mga natutunan namin and to obey your commands and your teachings. We give you back the glory and honor, Father. May the grace of the Lord Jesus Christ, the love and peace of God the Father, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us all. And everybody will say, Amen and Amen. Magandang umaga po sa lahat, magandang araw, magandang hapon dun sa aking mga friends at, of course, aking family na nandun sa Calgary that they are worshiping with us right now. Magandang hapon sa inyong lahat dyan. Of course, my sister-in-law, all other friends natin, sila Lenlen, sila Brother Joel, and all of those abroad that are worshiping with us today, and even yung ating mga visitors, you are always welcome here in our worship service. So magandang umaga again sa inyong lahat, magandang araw, magandang gabi, magandang hapon. Have a very blissful week. Stay safe and be reminded always that we are sent in every situation and every circumstance. God bless.